Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. On my previous videos, I did a couple of thrift flips on a set of old coffee tables. I crafted a longer piece into an upholstered bench and a shorter piece into a Moroccan style table. While working on the longer piece, I realized the drawer would not be able to open and close properly with the cushion in place, so I removed it and fitted a 1x3 board to fill the gap. One of you guys asked me if I was going to do anything with this drawer, and I said yes. I was planning to make another DIY project out of it. And here we are today. We are going to give this drawer a new lease on life and make it beautiful once again. I first painted the drawer with the same blend of Annie Sloan's chalk paints on the tables. Two parts of green mixed with one part of navy, and then applied two coats on the drawer. If you have seen my previous videos with those two tables, you know that although I used the same blended color to paint these pieces, I applied a different finish on each one of them. For today's project, I'm going to distress this piece after the paint has dried, to make it look aged and has a bit history on it. The most simple and straightforward method to distress wood furniture is to sand some of the paint off. This technique works great on painted wood. I just use a 200 grit sand sponge to sand the areas that tend to get bumped or scratched naturally. You can also soften any edges or corners that look too sharp, so the surface appears to be naturally aged. I want to make an end table to fill the corner of my living room, so I need to add four legs on the bottom of the drawer. In order to do that, I need to make a frame around the drawer and run two boards underneath it. few months ago, I went to a warehouse estate sale, and there were many tools and woodwork materials for sale. I saw a pile of wooden table legs in the corner. There were 7 of them in total, only $1 for each, so I took them all. I stained the legs using the same color as the frame, minwax wood finish, color is dark walnut. I then attached them to the bottom boards using angled brackets and screws that I bought at Lowe's for a few dollars. I then applied 1 coat of Annie Sloan's clear wax to the entire piece. I didn't like these white plastic feet on the bottom of each leg, so I removed them and replaced them with these clear floor protectors. I didn't use the original drawer knobs, as I found these wooden knobs from Lowe's for only 90 cents each. I stained them the same color as the legs. They are a perfect match with the rest of the piece, which giving it a rustic and a vintage feel. I enjoy transforming these thrifted items into elegant pieces, and being able to use some creativity in doing this was perhaps the best part. To get the high-end vibes to your home, sometimes it doesn't have to cost you a lot of money, but it will look like it did. That's it for this time, guys. If you like this video, please give it thumbs up and subscribe. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you next time.